Thank you. Good early evening to all of you. My name is Jonathan Swartz, and I'm the Artistic Director for Madeline Island Chamber Music. It's my pleasure to welcome you here to our concert with the Jupiter String Quartet. For those of you that have attended some of our previous programs this summer, you've heard me talk a little bit about our programming in the context of American identity in classical music. And you have noticed that we featured a lot of Dvorak this summer, and I've talked about his time in America in the 1890s and how influential he was in trying to encourage composers to find an American voice in music, a uniquely American voice. And he also led the way with an example in some of the compositions that he wrote while in our country when he was inspired by a lot of the indigenous music that he was hearing. This evening, we get to hear a work of Dvorak's that he started while he was in the United States, but he completed when he went back home to Bohemia. And this particular work, we get to hear more of Dvorak's Slavic roots and influences. Now, this idea of using indigenous influences to find a unique voice in music has been embraced by other composers throughout history. Béla Bartók is one very famous one. We know as an ethnomusicologist, he studied and categorized all of the folk songs that he was hearing, folk music. And so Béla Bartók's music definitely reflects indigenous influences from his homeland. We get to hear a work tonight by Bartók that was actually the last composition he wrote before he left Hungary. And he left Hungary to come to the United States. So we have a little bit of a juxtaposition of Dvorak leaving the US to go back home and Bartók leaving Hungary to come to the United States. Now, of course, Bartók was escaping fascism and he ended up spending the rest of his life in the United States. We also feature this evening a composer who comes from one of the great musical families in the United States, the Marsalis family. And of course, we know of Wynton Marsalis and think of all of the jazz influences there. We get to hear a string quartet by Wynton Marsalis that really reflects a lot of the indigenous New Orleans influences, the Creole people, and their history in New Orleans. And so he's really capturing that in his music. So we've got a lot of continuity and little threads in the repertoire that we're going to hear this evening. Our artists this evening are great friends of Madeline Island Chamber Music. I was thinking this evening about some of the improvements we've made in our clubhouse here, where we've actually changed some of our lighting to be LED lighting so the performers wouldn't get as hot on stage. And then I thought, it's not going to make a difference tonight with the Jupiter Quartet because they are so passionate and they're so energized in their playing that actually, it's a little warning for those of you in the front row. I am sure the heat is still going to emanate from this stage this evening. As always, I really appreciate you joining us for all these concerts. I do look forward to seeing you at our future programs. And now for the music. Please join me in welcoming to the stage the Jupiter String Quartet.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you all so much for joining us this afternoon. On behalf of the quartet, I just wanted to first say a huge thank you to Jonathan Swartz and the whole team at Madeline Island Chamber Music. It's a really special place, thanks to all their hard work, and it's just wonderful to be their colleagues. And then, most importantly, a big thank you to the students. It's so inspiring to watch you work during the week. Your concerts were unbelievable this afternoon, and the future of music and this art form of string quartets is in such great hands. So thank you for taking our crazy advice and being so respectful, diligent workers, and most importantly and most heartwarming to me was the support that you show for each other. That's really special. So a big round of applause for all the students. So Jonathan already spoke so eloquently about some of the threads and themes of our program. So I'll just briefly say that this idea of home is so important in these three works. And I think maybe it's on the minds of some students who are departing today. It's probably a bittersweet moment. So, you know, Wynton Marsalis turned to the music of his home city, New Orleans, when he wrote his wonderful string quartet. Bartok, as Jonathan mentioned, was being forced to leave his home with the rise of fascism in Eastern Europe, and Dvorak was returning to his home. So you'll hear, I think, each composer's feelings about that in the works today. So we'll play next, last quartet of Béla Bartok, which is probably one of the saddest pieces written for string quartet. Each movement, the first three movements, begin with introductions marked mesto, which means sad in Italian. And eventually those introductions turn into a slow movement at the end of the piece, so that the sadness sort of overwhelms the entire work. It's a very sorrowful piece. I think you can hear that his mother was dying and that he was leaving his home country. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.